Inside my colleague Dick Vitale, we're here to call tonight's matchup between the Rhode Island Rams and the Virginia Commonwealth Rams. And here we have our two players who are the focus of our star watch for today's game. And of course, here's our starting lineup.
As long as these two point guards are on the court, the ball is going to be in good hands, Brad.
We're set for the tip-off. And after all the anticipation, we're underway. The pass, kicks it out. 10 seconds. Way out on top, controlling the ball, off the mark, and they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside, and everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts, you can run screens, you can run back screens, you can do a lot of things on a perimeter, get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
For the bucket, scorches the net. Had a momentary look from three-point land. He shoots the jumper, and nice-looking jumper in the lane. Now getting set up here in a four-round-one.
I love the four-round-one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
They work it around the perimeter. Looking for the pick now.
Hey, the two-man game is great to watch when you have an intelligent dribbler and a skilled big man.
Our three-prong attack tonight, ladies and gentlemen. I'm Brad Nessler with Dick Vitale and our friend EA Aaron Andrews checking in from the sideline. On the left side. And up. Nope. All right, let's check in third member of our team again. Here's Aaron Andrews.
Dick and Brad, I'm sure you can hear and see Coach yelling from the sidelines. He wants the team to start forcing the issue on offense. In his opinion, the tempo needs to increase. Based on his team's personnel and his coaching philosophy, I guess he feels that this will give his team a better chance at getting the win. Guys?
Our trusty sideline reporter, Aaron Andrews, keeping everyone on their toes there on the sideline. Stolen. On the wing. In the lane.
They're having a rough time getting them to drop, Brad. They should take it to the basket and get some easy hoops.
They go into the low block. Goes up for two. Off the glass and no good. Matthew handles the pass. Here comes a pick.
Hey, ball screens are such an important part of the game these days. Guys are so creative when it comes to using that ball screen.
Gliding in for the jam.
Sliding and gliding. Nobody rotated over. The defense moves so slowly.
Work it around the arc. Controlling the ball. Lewis comes up with it.
Now you gotta get back. Don't allow him to have numbers.
He drains the bucket. Baseline. The Rams looking to attack now in transition. For two.
They come away with a basket off the break.
that, we've got a pause in the action. More NCAA basketball coverage coming up right after this. Can we expect a little change in direction here, Dick?
I wouldn't be surprised if the schemes change somewhat.
On the left side. Takes the jumper. Busts the jumper. There's a look at the current tempo for the game.
Well, Brad, as the meter indicates, the game has been pretty balanced in terms of tempo. Some short possessions and a few longer ones.
The point guard with the ball. The fadeaway jumper. He misses the fadeaway. Gave it up. He puts up the tray and score it. He's getting lost on every move.
We got to see more heart on defense.
He puts up the J. Scorches the net with a J. Stolen away. Swatted from behind.
Never saw him coming, Brad.
He can't let this guy have the uncontested shot.
He just got to dig in and play some D.
Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. There's the rejection. They get out on the break. Both teams are looking to get something going here. For the bucket, he buries it. Well, you know, basketball was like nutrition, Dick. His game would be broken down into the two major food groups, and that's passing and scoring.
It doesn't matter if you're a scorer and passes well or a good passer who can score. There will always be a spot for you on a team.
Bust the J. On the dribble, gives it up. Goes up. Knocks it down.
That basketball.
Set up in their zone motion.
Nice low post play. Good entry to the box. I wish somebody would knock down a jumper. Hey, that guy had 1,400 on his boards. And look at him running out there like a wacko. Oh, man. Look at that wacko.
Now they work it around the perimeter. Terrell picks up the foul. First personal foul. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
And there's a look at the young freshman.
Hey, Brad, a first-year player starting his college career. Really exciting times in front of this young man. Drained it. Nothing but nylon. NBA.
Goes up for two. He drains the shot. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well,
and has it rejected.
Defense did a great job with that blocked shot.
Gave it up for two. Off the glass and no good. On the outside, unloads a three. Nails a sweet jumper. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior.
Ten to shoot now. He tries to beat the clock.
Excellent jump shot right there.
We take a look here at each team's tempo, Dick.
Hey, the key to this game is not just who will set the tempo, but who can control it throughout the game.
He goes up with it. Nails the jumper. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Well, here we have a look at one of the sophomores for this team.
Well, Brad, he's still maturing. With your underclassmen, it's about improvement day by day, year after year.
Terrible free throw. Second shot is good. Offensively, they get into their zone motion. Trying to feed inside. Jumper. They get it to go. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
That's good. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
Great recognition by both players. The backdoor cut is one of those types of plays you love to see.
Tries for two. Tickles a twine. And now getting set up here in a four round one.
Well, the four round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Down inside, loose ball save with a bucket, gets it to go. Time to pick up the defense here now. So Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Ten seconds on the shot clock. With a big shot. They got it. The Rams set up in their zone motion.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
Puts up the jumper. Missed the jumper. Tillman handles the feed. Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Bust the jumper. Looking to move it around the perimeter. He pulls up with a jumper. Can't connect. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Rams have not done a good job of playing an up-tempo style. As you can tell, the coaching staff has been pretty animated over here on the sidelines. They are begging their players to push the ball and look to attack offensively. After all, that's their team style of play. Brad?
Thanks, EA, our third member of our team and our sideline reporter, keeping us up to date with what's taking place behind the scenes and around the bench. Good job, EA. Working it around the perimeter. Goes up for two. He's money with the shot. A great backdoor pass right there, Dick.
They got caught sleeping. Great execution, great timing. A beautiful backdoor pass.
On the dribble, gives it up. Takes his jumper.
Another brick, baby. Building a new arena.
They're going to call this one a backcourt violation, Dick.
You can't make mistakes like that too often, Brad.
Let's take a look at this young guy's great performance tonight, Dick.
I tell you, as a coach, Brad, it's always nice to have a player surprising step up and perform better than expected. We'll have to keep a close eye on him moving forward.
And he goes with a spin.
I tell you, feel the defensive player on your hip going one way, and you spin back the other way.
Strips the ball loose.
Pushing in transition. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
About 6 minutes remaining. Now trying to feed the low block. Now the turnaround jumper. Missed it. On the left side. Number 45 is... He took it hard to the rack and got the foul.
Well, that's what his coach likes to see. His boys going hard to the hole and not settling for the jump shot.
Here's another solid junior, Dick.
You can never have enough leadership on your roster. If you're a coach who's lucky enough to have a couple of upperclassmen, you're definitely at an advantage. Up and inside!
He draws a foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. Misses the first shot. Second shot. A great trap initiated by the defense. Too much. That's a foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nessler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots. You know, with him in the lineup, they've got one of the toughest things to get in sports. Experience. But remember, Brad, experience doesn't always come from being on the court. It comes in many different ways.
Makes those free throws count. Let's go back on that campus as BMOC. Big man on campus, baby.
Tries to get around the trap, but he can't do it.
Well done. Great trap.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits the foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
He goes to the free throw line. He sinks it. They have found their stroke at the stripe tonight, Dick.
This has always been an excellent free throw shooting bunch.
And he got them both. They're shooting extremely well from the stripe tonight, Dick.
Yeah, they're making their coaches look good for making them shoot extra free throws every day.
Looking for a good shot. For two. Oh, yes. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Looking for a good shot. Tries for two. Knocks it down. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
He looks for three. Off the mark. The Rams are going into their zone motion offense now.
Look at that spacing. Silly mistake.
Thompson receives the pass.
Excellent spacing. That's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Tries a three. Poor decision. He has no width of block. Number 45's modest performance is bringing down his confidence level.
He needs to take a deep breath, refocus, and get after it. Trying to go inside.
Jumper off the mark. Isolated on the outside. They're working around the arc looking for the open. Nice rejection. Out of bounds and a change in possession. Side. Here's a double team. They work the perimeter with the J. Bust the J. Moving it around the perimeter. Gets the feed down low. Now the turnaround jumper.
Nothing but nylon. Nice, smooth turnaround jumper. The only negative, he's falling away. If he misses, he's got no rebound in the building.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Under.
I did a great job of the ball fake that created the up and under move. And good footwork. It's essential with an up and under move to utilize good footwork.
a missed shot. As we continue to track the game's tempo.
We've seen a combination of both short and long possessions here, Brad. Nothing wrong with that if that's your team's ideal style of play.
Trying to pack it inside.
Jumper didn't look pretty, I can tell you that. That baby was ugly.
About a minute remaining in the game clock. Well, this man's in trouble. And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key, as you said, Brad, is motion. You have to have good movement on the perimeter to set up the guy on the inside. And everything's keyed about the entry to the post player. When he gets the ball, you can run backdoor cuts. You can run screens. You can run back screens. You can do a lot of things on the perimeter. Get open layups off the key, getting the ball to the big guy on the interior.
Fires from long range. Nope. The Rams set up in their zone motion. Gave it up. Lobs it. Launches a three. Nails the J. At the half, the Rams trail by one. Virginia Commonwealth really showed no signs of rust with their shooting in the first half, Dick.
They certainly did. Their offensive execution was near perfection. Keeping it up will be the key.
Like they're going to go with a full court man-to-man press, Dick. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I'll tell you, that big guy they have that can step out and go inside is really special. He gives you that flexibility, which makes the offense multifaceted.
The Rams set up in their zone motion. On the dribble, gives it up. For the bucket. Got it. Let's go courtside. What do you got for us, Aaron?
The Rams have really taken advantage of their free throw line opportunities. Dick, you mentioned at the beginning of the game that this point would be important. And sure enough, up until this point, it has been. Their coach insisted that the strong play will have to continue in the second half. Brad?
All right, thanks, Aaron. Well, it commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
He goes to the line for the first time. He makes the first shot. They're seeing them all fall from the line tonight.
That's a crucial plus down the stretch, Brad.
And he doesn't miss that opportunity either. They're making good use of their free throw opportunities tonight.
Good free throw shooting teams seem to always give themselves a chance to win.
Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Gave it up. Hard foul. Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
He'll visit the charity stripe. Gets the first shot. They're nailing the free ones tonight, Mr. Vitale.
Hey, this is where you win and lose games, Brad.
Got them both.
He converts on that free throw line, and that's major.
And now, getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one, spacing's a key. You better have good spacing, and you better have people on the interior that can score with their back to the basket. If you got a big guy who can post up inside and who has passing ability, he's going to create opportunities for the guys on the perimeter.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Zone motion now. Goes up for two. Makes the shot. A great trap initiated by the defense. The ball stripped. Out on the right wing.
What a great steal. Defensive player was really right on top of that basketball.
Offensively, they get into their zone motion.
Great finish off the transition, Brad.
They work it around the perimeter. Looks at the three. Nails the jumper. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Number two is called for the foul. Well, I don't know if there's such a thing as a good foul, but that might have been one right there, Dick.
Hey, Mr. Nestler, I like that type of play. He's saying to the defense, no easy baskets for you. We're going to force you to make shots.
He'll look at a pair of free throws. He can't get one to fall. Second shot. That line is really being good to him tonight, Dick.
That line's always good, Brad. These guys just have to make good use of it.
Trying to feed the low block. And now the fadeaway jumper. And come up short. The Rams here running their zone offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
The crowd starting to chant.
Who says there's no such thing as a home court advantage?
Pushes it up. For two. He buries the shot. On the dribble, gives it up. He attempts the jump shot. Missed it. Nice shot. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
And a momentary look from three-point land. Takes the jumper. Off the mark. Now in transition. Number two is whistled for the foul. Oh, it looked like he had an easy basket coming up, but the defense commits a foul instead.
Great play there, Brad. He was able to foul him in order to prevent the easy basket.
Step to the line for the free throw.
Concentration. Got to concentrate.
Wait,
Rick
short.
City.
Can't buy one. Nice defensive rebound.
Men have got to get out and fill the lanes, Brad.
They're working around the perimeter.
I tell you, they all want to take it to the rack. High wire rack, baby.
Little tipsy dude, Dunkaroo.
Count that as a personal foul. Well, he commits an intentional foul there to prevent the easy basket.
Well, it's a smart play, Brad, especially if you can afford to use a personal foul. I like his mentality. No easy basket.
To the line for an easy one. Got it from the free throw line. Gets two at the charity stripe. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I love the four around one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to get help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
Some trouble here. The Rams now looking to run their stuff against this zone.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone, to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Yeah, nothing like having those legs, man, where you bounce right off the floor.
And now getting set up here in a four-round one.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
About 10 seconds left on the shot clock. Shot. Not a great decision there to shoot the ball.
Yeah, that's horrible, Mr. Nestler. Horrible shot selection.
Tries for two. He gets that one to fall. I get a feeling they've changed things up a little bit, Dick.
We'll see what they come up with, Brad.
Zone offense now. Cross court. Here's a block from behind.
My man was on a mission.
They'll work it around the arc. For the bucket. Drains the shot.
Their defense is absolutely horrible.
They are not putting up much of a fight.
Great pressure, great double team, really explosive.
And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
10 on the shot clock. Can he beat the buzzer? And score it. The Rams running their zone offense here, Dick.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
It into a double team on a post. Knocked it down. And now getting set up here in a four round one.
Well, the four round one motion offense is a good offense when a team has a big guy who can play with his back toward the basket and another big who can play on the perimeter. A lot of teams will play this offense.
Ten on the shot clock. With the big shot. The missed shot. Matthew handles the pass. Now they work it around the perimeter. He tries the jumper. Busts the jumper. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up, and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior, and they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
The Rams have quite a few seniors in their lineup, which definitely is to their benefit.
It is, Brad. Seniors may be the only reason why coaches sleep at night. They rarely make bad decisions, and you can trust them on the court.
Tries to beat the buzzer. They got it. And there's sort of a snapshot of our game tempo.
Long possessions, a few fast breaks is the reason for that, Brad.
Goes up for two. Shot off. Turnover by the freshman on the left side. Look to get it to the inside. He shoots the jumper. Scorches the net with a J. So, Dick, so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
On the outside. And the ball is saved. Great job. Turnover committed by the senior.
Trying to get that ball movement, get that good spacing.
The Rams in attack mode. That's his fourth foul, and he may have to go to the bench.
He's got to watch himself. He's no good to his team on the bench.
Well, if there is such a thing as a good foul, that was probably it.
Sure was, Brad. He fouled to prevent the easy basket.
Steps to the line for the freebie. First shot is no good. Second one, no good. Gave it up. with a fadeaway jumper. Look at that follow through. Dick, he's just taking too many bad shots.
And I don't think he's done yet, Brad.
Work the perimeter.
Spacing so important. Get 15 to 17 feet apart.
Now looking to create with a ball screen.
And a pick and roll is one play that so many teams use these days. A great way to buy a step for the dribbler.
Looking to move it around the perimeter. He puts up the J. Jumper won't go. Number 45 handles the pass. Dumps it in. Ball down low. Puts it on the floor. Toronto fadeaway. He drains it. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
I tell you, the four around one makes it tough to defend the big guy on the interior with one guy. It really does. You got to get help on him, and if you don't get help, he's going to have a field day on the interior. I tell you, what a nice turnaround jump shot. Soft as velvet, fading away, impossible to block.
Now in transition. There was no doubt about that one.
There it is, Jam City.
So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Working it around the perimeter. Outside jumper. Nope. He cleans the glass.
Up and inside.
About 6 minutes remaining. Looking for a good shot. Goes up with it. Missed the jumper. On the dribble, gives it up. Tries for two. He doesn't get the hoop to fall. Gave it up. For the bucket. Too strong.
The athleticism in some of these kids, Brad, I'll tell you, it's incredible.
Now getting set up here in a four-round-one.
I love the four-round-one, especially when you got a big guy who can pass the ball exceptionally well as score. Now you got to give help on him, and it leaves people open on the perimeter, and they better be able to make that open jump shot.
On the elbow, they feed down to the low block. Goes up for two. Can't put it down. Number 15 gets the ball. Down low, there's a drop step. He gets the rejection. I don't think they'll be able to get those easy ones inside, Dick.
That's right, Brad. The object of a good zone is to nullify all shots inside the three-point line.
He can't get the bucket to fall. On the right side. From right of the circle, they get it to go. About 4 minutes remaining on the game clock. Looking for a good shot.
Turnover by the senior. Look at that spacing.
From beyond the arc, nails the J. It might be safe just to start that bus up. I think this one's over.
Imagine, I was a bad teacher. Time to watch this game tape, baby, to see where you went wrong.
They've got him right where they want him, Dick. And they go into their motion offense, working with four around one here.
Well, you know, the key to this offense, you better have a big guy on the inside who can be effective, and then a big guy who has versatility who can step out. And they certainly have the elements to make this offense work.
Now with about 10 seconds to shoot. Puts it up quick to beat the clock. Missed it. The Rams set up into their zone motion offense.
Well, the key to zone motion offense is you got to get good ball movement. If you get good ball movement to get the zone to really slide and use the skip pass to make it tough for that zone to adjust.
Excellent spacing, that's so important to a good offensive set. It's even more important to have talented guards like they have.
Yeah, that helps. Looks like they're setting up into their zone motion. Isolated on the outside, they work it around the arc, looking for the open jumper. Drains it.
The D has no energy left on offense.
Their life is being sucked out of them right now in the defensive end. Getting set up here in a four-round one.
I tell you, the four-round one is keyed by the big guy inside, but the four people on the perimeter better be able to make perimeter shots. And it's great when you got a big guy who has the multi-talented ability to step out and make the open jump shot.
The Rams now running a zone offense.
Hey, one thing that works well against zones is overloading the side. Overload a side and force the defense to shift out of their desired position.
There's a double team waiting there from three-point land. Can't connect. Pushes it up. We're at the one-minute mark from three-point territory. That's an ill-advised shot. I don't think that's the guy you want shooting from the three-point line.
Brad, I can guarantee you that he's not the guy they want shooting the ball.
Tries for two. You betcha. So Dick's so important now at the point. The point guard will set things up and the other four will go to work.
Well, you know what they're doing is a four around with a post guy on the interior. And they're trying to get that ball to the inside, but they're playing with four people on the exterior.
Play will come from the baseline. He puts up the runner. He can't get the hoop to fall. Thompson receives the pass. Inside.
Double team now, bad angle.
The missed shot. Pushes it up with a big shot off the mark. Virginia Commonwealth is on the receiving end of a blowout.
After a game like that, it's hard to believe that these two teams were close in the standings.
Brad Nessler saying so long for my partners, Dick Vitale and Aaron Andrews. Thanks for joining us.